Hey everybody, it's Ryan. Welcome back to How Farms Work. We are in my truck today, and we're going to go for a short little ride. Now, there have been some recent developments going on in our county, and it's been quite huge. Now, I initially heard about this first a few months ago, actually about a year ago now is when I first heard that they were talking about putting one of these in. But the representative has started to come around more about a couple months ago, and whatnot. So I've been learning more about it. I haven't done any looking into it, mostly because in the past few months we've been busy with harvesting, and I've actually been more busy this harvest, after this harvest, than I have in previous years with the other projects that I've been doing on the side, which some of I'll be showing videos on. Anyway, what's been going on in Grant County is that there is a proposed 200 megawatt solar facility that is that they're trying to get put through, that they're wanting to build just north of the main farm. So this solar facility is so huge, it's actually going to surround our main farm here on two sides. Now, a while back, we had some representatives stop in from NextEra, and they, which is a Florida business, by the way, they are pretty much a private company that will, I think they might be publicly shared, but don't hold me to that. Anyway, they are a company that comes through and builds these projects kind of on a contractual basis with the utility companies. So they are planning on putting in a 200 megawatt solar facility just north of the farm and west of the farm. And the facility is absolutely huge that they're proposing. And since this is kind of a new concept to me, I don't really know a whole lot about the project. I think that if the project goes through, it's going to be interesting to follow how things go with, you know, how they shape the land and stuff like that. You know, whether they bring in bulldozers and have to flatten the land out, because the area that they're planning on putting it in, the driftless region, isn't exactly the flattest land. And 10 years ago, there was not a solar facility this size anywhere in the world. So it's going to be interesting to follow. You know, we have our own concerns about the project itself. They asked us if we were interested in putting in some of our ground into the solar facility. We said no for our own personal reasons. Then I've been talking with other farmers in the area to kind of get their opinion on the project, what they think of it. And there's been some things going on behind the scenes that does kind of get me concerned a little bit. But I am interested to kind of research these solar facilities more and look into how these projects go forward. And I'm going to be learning a lot. So what we're going to do today is we are going to start from the main farm here in Rockville and head north. We're going to see how long we have to drive to reach the northern end of the proposed solar facility. And I don't even know how many minutes it's going to take to get to the other side. But I'm going to we're already in my truck. We're gonna head out the driveway, head north. I'm gonna drive at 55 and just kind of talk about the area a little bit. And I know that the camera, you guys always comment how it doesn't really look too hilly here, but this is actually some of the more flattest ground in the area. And even the flat ground is still, you know, pretty hilly. I mean, we have our ground in contours. Just helps slow that erosion, which are the strips between corn and beans that you guys always see. So I do have my own concerns with this facility as well. One of the biggest ones that I personally have with it is glare. Since I do have, you know, the camera out here pretty frequently, there's huge, you know, the hill over here is pretty big, and I am worried that I'm gonna catch some glare when I'm filming. And I am worried that it's going to affect, you know, some of the shots in our videos. You know, you guys always hear me talk about how the driftless region is absolutely gorgeous for its rolling hillsides and stuff like that. And I am slightly concerned about glare and other things as well, but I really don't know enough about them to be able to talk about them too much yet. So I'll probably follow up in another video sometime in the future after I've done some research on solar facilities like this. And to update you guys on the project as it goes along. Should be interesting to follow. Another thing is that there is a meeting here in Potosi that NextEra is hosting where people can come in and ask any questions. So if you guys have any experience or any of questions that you guys might have if a project like this came in your area, feel free to go down in the comment section and leave a comment, because I have my own questions, but there's just so much to it. You know, there might be an aspect that I might not be thinking of, something that I should be concerned about or shouldn't be concerned about. Yeah, just go ahead and leave a comment if you guys have one of these facilities in your area, or if you have any experience dealing with companies like this. So we're going to head out, start driving up the road. I'm going to start the stopwatch to see how long it takes us to get through the facility. But we just left Rockville. We are heading north on Highway 61. So we farm what's on the right and left of the road here. And this solar facility on the highway is going to start right here to the right and left. Fun fact, the farm on the left and on the right over here used to be Grandpa's farm back in the day. That would be Dad's dad. So we've got a hog facility on the right. And coming up here, we have some grain bins on the right side. Now, part of something that's really interesting to me about this whole solar project that they're proposing is that they're proposing it right in an area that has had a lot of damage to it from storms in the last 10 or 15 years. Some of our longer viewers might actually remember some of the damage on this farm in particular that happened. And I got, you know, I drove by it and caught some of the damage from it. Those bins are all actually, I think most of them are new, or they've all had some work on them, just because there were some straight line winds. It wasn't even a tornado that came through and had pretty much totaled out some of those bins. So everything that you see is still within the solar project that they're proposing. Something that I wonder if we should be worried about, since we are going to be downwind from these panels, is since there has been storm damage on these properties more than once in the last 10, 15 years, do we have to worry about any of these panels coming loose and, you know, coming through one of our windows? I believe the project doesn't go this far to the right, but it still goes on the left up here. And I believe it's going to come, it'll still be on the left. Still be on the left. I believe the northernmost point of the project is going to be right along here to the left. It's going to end right there. Now the project itself is actually going to extend further south, but it won't go any more south than us, because we're at the southern edge of the proposed project. And in the outline that they had published in the local paper, we weren't actually included in the proposed area. But I think what they're trying to do is get to the substation on Stage Road there. And right now, I don't think they have a way to get over there. I know that they were trying really hard to get us to sign in, mostly because I think they wanted a way to get over to that substation, but they don't have a way to cross Ebbing Road, to my knowledge, yet. Because not all the farmers in the area are going along with it. I'm also rather worried about things like eminent domain, because one of the first times the representatives came to us, they had actually threatened us with using eminent domain to reach the substation down here on Stage Road, since they're going to need a way to get down there. And if they can't get enough farmers to sign in, they'll have to use that to reach the substation. Now, since NextEra is technically responsible for the project, and they're a Florida-based company, I was told by the company that, actually the project manager, that they don't have any eminent domain rights since they're a Florida company and they're working in Wisconsin. However, that doesn't apply necessarily to the local utility companies. So the local companies could say, hey, we've got this huge source of power here and we need to reach it. So that means that they could use eminent domain to cross through our property and use that to reach it. We were told about a couple different routes that they could take to reach the line that goes to the substation. And one of them actually goes, that they had initially told us, one of the routes was right through the pasture at my place, or they would have to cross between us and the neighbor along the property line there at Rockville. However, they wouldn't be able to cross directly from the neighbors, so they would have to go down the road, which means they would have to either build on our property or the neighbors along the road to get to that property line to get to another farm that is supposedly being put in. I haven't heard from those landowners, but I would assume that they are going in at, into the solar facility. It's going to be a huge project if it goes through. Some of my bigger concerns are, you know, what is kind of noise are we going to be dealing with? What kind of runoff are we going to be seeing on our farms from the project when it's being built and after the panels are installed and things like that. So here's the airport to the right. That's the Lancaster Municipal Airport. And it's within like, I think it's just over a mile from the northern proposed edge of the solar project. So that is pretty much the extent of the facility that they're planning on putting in. It does extend west and east some, but you guys can check out the satellite image of the proposed solar project. Like I said, they are planning on having a meeting in Potosi at the Holiday Gardens Monday, January 13th, I believe from 4:30 to 6:30. So I'm going to be there. If you guys are local, if you guys have any of your own questions that you'd like to go and ask, please, you know, go down to the meeting, ask them yourself. I will be there. I'll be there with a couple other farmers. I'd like to talk to other people who are locally about the project to see what their thoughts are on it. Like I said, if you guys have any questions that I should ask or that you can think of or any comments that you'd like to add down in the comment section, please do. And that should be pretty much it for this video. Just wanted to introduce the whole project to you guys because I will be following it more on my channel and talking about it. I think that if it goes through, it'll be interesting to see how the project goes, how we're affected by it, you know, with my YouTube channel and whatnot. Is there gonna be glare? I had actually gone to one of their previous meetings, which was held in Lancaster. I think it was actually the only other meeting that they've held so far. And they reassured me that they're painted, or they have like an anti-reflective coating on it. However, they're not totally sure where the panels are going to be sourced from. So if they aren't sure where they're going to be sourced from, and if the panels are anything like other solar panel facilities, there's probably going to be some glare there. So that's one of my biggest concerns. That's pretty much it. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Be sure to follow and be sure to stay in touch. I will keep you guys posted on any more developments with the solar project. Like I said, Holiday Gardens, January 13th, 4:30 to 6:30. If you guys are in the area, come down to the Holiday Gardens in Potosi. I feel like this hasn't really been talked about a heck of a whole lot. I don't feel like a lot of people know because even just this morning, I met someone else who had no idea that there was even a project coming in the area. So I like to spread awareness, and the more awareness that there is about a project like this, the better, because it is going to impact a lot of people, and it is an absolutely huge project. So with that, I'll see you next time, guys.